last time. In the past 20 hours, we have had the seas, gosh, go up 25, up to 30 feet, and it is blowing. So we're caught in between those two lows. We had the first one pass, and the second one came, and it's just a couple of, about 100 miles off our port side to the north, but there is quite the heave here. We just passed into the Porcupine Seabight. Well, we're well into it, actually. We're about 115 nautical miles southwest of the coast of Ireland, Kerry. So hopefully, if we keep pushing, we'll catch a little lee before we get into the Celtic Sea. And we're bound right now for the Celtic Sea, the Celtic Shelf, which is about 250 nautical miles east of our position. But we have been taking quite a beating. And we're certainly not going out on the deck today. And I've had to make quite a few rudder adjustments here. So as with the sea state, I'm having to adjust every few minutes here to try to keep our course. So we're swaying back and forth. We have a 10 to 15 degree difference sometimes, depending on how long I wait to get back to the wheel. But at least we don't have any mechanical casualties, so all's well in that department. Nothing wrong with the cargo, seems to be fastened. Is fine. Nothing's broken loose. But we are in a roller coaster ride now, as you can see. Let's go out on the bridge wing here so you can see the sea. Looking north. Oh boy. Enough of that. Let's go out on the starboard bridge wing here. Nothing on the radar. South. Eastbound. Now, I've had to slow her down a bit. Brought her back to about 115 RPM. And we're making turns for about 14 and a half knots. Now we've had just... Well, let's get back in. Well, I guess we can go up top and take a look around. Certainly don't want to go forward. Not in this sea, right? Let me get a better view of this. What we've been fighting the past 20 hours. Since last time, I mean, the seas have almost doubled. In some cases, gotta get back into the house here. Oh. It's brutal. No casualties, everything, air's running, compressor, everything seems to be going, main engine is fine. Now the problem we had at 18 knots when we were running about 123 RPM, we started to, about 10 hours ago, we started to experience a lot of propeller cavitation, so I brought her back. I mean, shuttering the whole bridge. It was really slowing us down, so I'm trying to keep the propeller in the water. Well, let's look at our course mate pit so far. Our position last time, and there we are. That's the Porcupine Seabight, which is that little area. There's our position. That slope going down off the ridge is the Seabight. There's the Celtic Sea, and there's the Irish coast. So hopefully we'll be able to catch a lee from there where the wind will calm down. Maybe the seas will break a bit, but once we get out into the sea, the Irish Sea is, I don't know if we're going to get a wash from the Irish Sea. I really don't. But we'll see when we get there. If we do, we may have some confused seas and it may slow down a bit more so we can catch the flooding tide off the Cornish coast. And if we can tuck in inside the Cornish coast with a flooding tide, it should lay down quite a bit and make our about a 200-mile run to Dover. Again, we still have quite a ways to go. You can hear this. The ship's taking quite a beating in this, but she's handling fine. No more cavitation. Just as long as you don't mind making these rudder adjustments and hanging on with a sleigh ride. It's not very comfortable. Let's take a look and see how she's handling this. Well, we'll try not to spill any coffee, but I can't guarantee that. Now there's a companionway that runs from the forward compartment of the engine, and she runs right up through the holes. So you don't have to go out on deck to access the holes. And we've checked everything. Concern was the four holes with the automobiles. They seem to be doing fine. There's a lot of adjustments in this one, but I wouldn't call it a white knuckler, but it's pretty close, and it certainly is tiring. There's no time for rest. As you can see, I've been running around the bridge. I keep watching, looking for something to go wrong. So far, so good. We should be, we're off the Cornish coast next time, hopefully. We're close. And we'll see what happens. May it only get better once we get inside. about another 175 miles, and we'll be off of Cork. Then I'm going to come south a bit, make our turn into the channel now. Again, I'm watching the tide change very closely. I really don't want to be there when, if it's ebbing, if the water's ebbing, I'm meeting the seaway like this. So we'll see you next time. And I'll leave you with this. Don't forget to subscribe and give the thumbs up. We'll see you off in the English Channel, hopefully, next time. See you soon.